behind the guy.
Windsor foul number 8, Dizzy Sundaridge, his second personal, his second. Thank you. Second violation, Windsor ball.
Welcome back, everybody, for some second quarter action between the Lancers and the Lions. Lancers start the quarter with possession. Leon Phillip with the ball, but he loses possession. That's okay, because the Lancers get it, and they get the bucket as well.
So they're now up by 8 points.
Akeem Isaac with the ball.
They're really going to have to keep their eye on Leon Phillip. Like I said, he's the team leader in points and rebounds. He's a quick, tall, strong forward for the Lancers, and they're really going to have to keep an eye on him because he is going to be getting a lot of minutes, like I said. He's going to have the ball in his hands a lot of the time.
What seems interesting to me is that we've seen Akeem Isaac bring up the ball a lot tonight, as opposed to David Tyndale, who did so last night. But it seems to be working, as the Lions are now just down by 6 points. Lancers with possession. Josh Collins with the ball. He passes it to Di Loretto. Now, with the skip pass and the shot from beyond three, and it's good from downtown. Now, David Tyndale bringing the ball up, calling out the play, but he's driving, and there's a foul.
It's going to be an interesting matchup to watch, the matchup between the point guards on both sides, both number four, both second team All-Stars on the respective side of the OUA second team. David Tyndale on the east side and Josh Collins on the west side. It's going to be a fun matchup to watch. These two are well acquainted with each other.
Little spin move and the shot goes up, but there's another foul. This game very physical. We've seen both teams go to the free throw line numerous times already.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for Tufegic in this game. Yesterday he had 25 points and 10 rebounds, a double-double, and the leader of the Lions in that game against the Mustangs. Things aren't going to be as easy for him tonight going against, as I said, Leon Phillip. He's a strong, strong forward and tough to play both sides against.
Christian Koldea being replaced by Matthew Zywobrowski. The substitution is made. And that was Leon Phillip with a successful free throw. And he'll have another chance right here. That's good. It's now Tyndale with the ball. Bit of trouble finding the open man, so he goes in the key by himself with the shot, and it's good. That's a good effort by David Tyndale.
Yeah, as I said, in the second half last night, that's what he really moved to after going 0 for 6 from the field in the first half. He started driving the ball, and it really started working for him because he's a speedster. He's a quick guy, and it doesn't look like so far Josh Collins can handle him.
Di Loretto with the lucky bounce, as it's good for two. As the Lancers now lead 28-17, an 11-point lead. Tyndale with the ball, looking for the play. Once again, being forced to drive to the net, unsuccessful this time. And it looks like we're going to have a jump ball here. And York will get possession of the basketball. Isaac looking for the inbound. Fedic with the ball. Not sure what the ball is here. No basket, though. We're going to have a substitution here. Raheem Isaac back on the court.
Replacing the other Isaac. Akeem Isaac out, Raheem Isaac in.
Lancers doing a good job with the fake shot as they fooled the York Lions twice, but they were unsuccessful to score. Now here's Tyndale with for three. No good. As De Loretto regains possession. And a nice defensive play there by Raheem Isaac. Another substitution here. Josh Collins back on the court. He will inbound this basketball. 6:49 left in the second quarter. Collins with the ball. Tyndale making his way up the court. Slowing it down. Calling out the play. No. Tyndale once again with the ball. Now Isaac. Shot clock violation. Lancers will get possession.
Great defense there by the Lancers. The Lions could not find anything. No one could get open. And when someone did, that was Raheem Isaac. Got the foul, jumped, tried to go for the three, but realized I probably shouldn't shoot this because it's going to get blocked.
Lancers only leading by 11, but they have showed us why they are ranked fifth, playing some good defense and usually capitalizing on their scoring chances as Tyndale makes it up the court once again, quarterbacking the offense. We've seen Isaac move the ball. Now it's him having a bit of trouble, though, beating his man. And now with the shot, and it's good. Nothing but net from David Tyndale. He cuts the lead to 9. Now it's Collins. Can't get a shot off. So the ball goes back up top, and they cycle it once again. Collins regains possession. Now with the shot, but it's no good. York with the rebound. Ziobrowski with possession of the basketball right now. Not sure what to do with it, though, as no one's open. Loses possession. Now, Collins with the easy layup. Seems now these two teams are just trading chances with each other. Lions are going to need to tighten up defensively. The timeout is called here.
Yeah, they're going to have to watch those turnovers. They've been leading in turnovers at the moment. Yeah, they're really going to have to watch the play on the offensive side, not try to get too pretty. Really keep it simple and keep the passes simple. Keep the game plan simple. And they should be close to being successful. I don't know if I can go right to saying they'll be successful because this Lancers team, as we've mentioned, a very good team.
Teams back on the court after some advice from the coaching staff. work. We'll start with the ball with 5:12 left in this game. In this half, pardon me, as the Lancers lead by 11 points. Tyndale with the shot once again, but it's no good. He's had a bit of trouble with his jumper tonight. Josh Collins dishing it out. And there's they pass it out. And now from three-point range, it's good. Tyndale with the ball again. And now Isaac, but it's no good. York continues to try to shoot, but there's a push, there's a foul on Josh Collins of the Lancers.
Good pressure in there by the basket, by the Lions, really, really making it tough for the defenders on the Lancers side to come down with it. But what I'd like to look at again, or talk about again, is how they're really bringing back their break up to the offensive zone with a lot of speed, really bringing it back fast and making it tough for the Lancers to get back and kind of set up their own defense.
Rados with the ball, dishes it out. Now a shot from three-point range, but it's no good. There's a tip. No one with possession. York gets it back. Just shot after shot, but no finish here. And the Lancers finally grab the ball. Now Diloretto fooling his man, and now with the shot, but it's no good. Close, but no cigar. Now Isaac on the other way with the nice bounce pass. But Tim stops it with his leg, and it goes out of bounds.
That good speed back there by Nana Tim to at least get a hand on that pass. Or else Tvecic would have gotten that point and made it a little bit of closer of a game. It's currently 33-21 for the Lancers.
Diloretto with possession, calling out the play. Trying to beat his man, and he does. This is in the key, and there's cycling the ball around the perimeter of the arc. And York will get the basketball.
Lazy pass there by Leon Phil. Looks like he was just playing a little bit of backyard basketball right there. Should have been a lot more professional with that pass there.
Rados in the key. Finds an open Isaac. And from downtown, it is good. As he cuts the lead to 9 points with 3 minutes left. Now the Lancers making a few substitutions, getting some fresh legs on the court. But York with possession of the ball.
A single-digit game for the Lions. Didn't reach for them. Oh, boy. That will be...
Basket no good. So the Lancers with possession now. And Diloretto, pardon me, will inbound this one. Ian Phillips trying to get possession, but there's a whistle blown. Most likely a foul. Yes, a foul, and that's on Christian Koldea of the Lions.
Thank you.
Capella. A lot of hustle in this game, and a shot from three, and it is good. Leon Phillip with the tray.
I really liked what Petrella did with the ball there after he had gotten the rebound, kind of reassessed things, pulled it around the corner, and ball eventually found its way to Liam Phillip. And as we've mentioned, that's the guy who you want the ball in his hands.
And there's going to be a jump ball here, and the ball will go to the Lancers. As this game has been physical from the opening tip-off, and the Lancers call a timeout. Dillaretta will inbound this as it goes to Petrella, who is pressured, but they get past half. Dillaretta once again as they cycle it beyond the arc. As I said, this game is getting very physical. Lots of fouls being handed out to both teams.
Coach on the Lancer side really upset with that foul. It was called a travel on the Lancer side. He was asking questions, how can you even call that? And I tend to agree with him there. I don't know how you can call that a traveling on the Lancers.
A bit of a lucky break for the Lions. As Isaac goes with the ball, but he is pressured with nowhere to go. But there's a foul. And this one will go to Ryan Christie. Aaron Rados inbounding the ball. He found Stefezic. And now it's Akeem Isaac, number 5, loses possession. And it goes out of bounds, but York will retain possession of the ball with 1:20 left in this second quarter.
Yeah, you saw Isaac on that last possession there, taking a little eye at the clock to see how much time they had left. You can really see that it's a little bit of desperation with 1:20 left in the second half to try and pull it in one digit.
The Lancers started off strong and got to an early lead, as the lead is now 12 points. But the Lions have stayed in the game, trading chances, and they haven't permitted the Lancers to break away from this game.
Yeah, they've really kept it within reach, and I think they've done it with speed. You can really see they're sticking to that fast break. And also on the defensive side, you saw on, I think it was the last possession before the Lancers, before they had called traveling on the Lancers. They threw
two. Right quick away. Double team on Petrella once he had gotten the ball from the inbound. And I like that. Keep it fast-paced. Keep it a fast-paced game. It started fast, and it really hasn't dwindled at all. It stayed quick, and I think that's where they have the advantage, is their speed in this game.
Christie there. Definitely not to the home crowd's delight. On day two of this opening weekend for York University Lions. Trellick, who loses possession of the ball, and it's Defezic with the slam! With authority as he hustles back on D. Now Petrelic having a bit of trouble crossing half, but he does successfully. Isaac all over him.
Isaac giving him a lot of trouble. He was the one who instigated that turnover on that last possession.
Lions with the ball now with 41 seconds left. The ball is now in Ihedu's hands. Now Rados goes for the drive with the easy layup. He cuts this lead to 10. Petrelic once again moving the ball up the court with patience. And patience indeed, not doing anything with the ball, looking for an open man. Lancer's shot goes up, but it's no good. But the rebound is also unsuccessful. Third time, no good. As we run out of time here, as the Lancers lead the Lions 38-28 at the end of the second half.
On that last possession there, I think that has really shown, just right in that possession, what has been the difference in this game. And it's been that pressure all around the basket for the Lancers. They've been really tough to compete against on the boards. And as we mentioned before the game, that is something that the Lions are really going to have to keep hold of. That is the rebounds. They were so great last night with the rebounds. They were good in the first quarter, leading in rebounds 11-7 as well. But that lead has dwindled for the rebounds, and they're going to have to keep hold of the offensive and defensive boards to give themselves more chances and give the Lancers less chances.
All right, so next thing you guys are going to have to do, they're going to be starting off the back of the basketball. From there, you're going to dribble to the baseline, opposing side, come back to back, turning. They're going to put on the inner body of the basketball shorts. Then from there, they have to proceed to make a three-point shot, and then a second three-point shot. And the first thing you do is make a shot, and make your own. All right? Back there.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Tait Mckenzie Center here at York University. I'm Pierre Chabot, joined here by Adrian Falangi, as we are set to start the second half of this game. York currently trailing by 10 to the Windsor Lancers, who are ranked 5th. They start things off in the Lancer zone. And Tufegic with the shot, but the effort goes to Isaac. Josh Collins on the other way, scores the basket.
Good offensive rebound there by the Lions in the first half. That's what really kept them close, was their ability to gather offensive and defensive rebounds. But the thing that is the difference really in this game so far is the shooting percentage. Not so much from field goal, from field goal range, because it's only 6% difference there, 44% for the Lancers and 38% for the Lions. But if you have to look at it, you have to look at from the distance beyond the arc. The Lancers are shooting really well. They're 15% three-point range. The Lions only 12.5%.
Also important to note that both teams could open up small bakeries with the amount of turnovers they have. Windsor at 11 and York at 12, and now a hard foul called. Charging.
That was a hard set.
So Lancers will get possession here from the offensive foul. Josh Collins gets the ball back after inbounding it. Now, not challenged, goes for the rebound, but a nice block from Daniel Tulloch. But there's a foul from Akeem Isaac. Therefore, Seferovic is at the line shooting too.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what happened there with the defense for the Lions. Josh Collins was given pretty much a free lane right to the basket, and that led to the foul.
Akeem Isaac bringing up the ball, as Tyndale is on the bench right now. And a big block from Leon Phillip. But it's going to be a foul.
Yeah, they're going to have to keep doing that to stay close in this game. We've mentioned that Lansing has the size advantage in this game. But I think you have to give the advantage in speed and aggressiveness to the Lions. They are a quick team, and they need to keep driving to the basket to either have the Lancers commit the foul or be able to get some in-close baskets.
The shot is good. Collins bringing up the ball, crosses half, and he's challenged by Isaac. A big matchup there. They cycle the ball around the arc, and there's a shot from downtown, and it's good. Osentola Jr. with the tray. Now on the other side, no good. So Collins, who passes it to Di Loreto, but it's no good. But the Lancers retain the ball as they cycle the ball once again, trying to get a play going here. Di Loreto with a nice move and the shot, and no one there to get the defensive rebound, but there's a foul, and two shots will be attempted.
And great job there by Osentola Jr. He had the offensive rebound, he had the 2 points on one side, leading to an offensive rebound and a defensive rebound, and once again another offensive rebound. He's been really good coming out in the second half, and he will shoot for two right here.
Osentola missing the first basket. Score here, 42 for the Lancers, 31 for the York Lions. Fedjic with the ball. York having a bit of trouble penetrating that key, but now they're successful at it. A shot goes up, but it's no good. And the Lancers get the ball. The pace has certainly slowed down here in the second half as compared to the first one. But the game is still very physical.
Yeah, that could have been Coach Chris Oliver's talk at halftime for the Lancers was slow down the pace a little bit, because as we mentioned, it seems that the Lions have that speed advantage. So a good way to counteract against that speed advantage is keep it slower and don't let the speed really take hold of the defense on the Lancers side.
Now it seems this Ahedindu's turn to bring up the ball. Now to Fedjic with the big drive and the layup, and it's good. Good effort there by Nick Defedic, number 22 for the New York Lions.
Yeah, he didn't have too strong of a first half, only 3 points. This guy's coming off a double-double last night. He was the big reason that the Lions won. Wow, big block there. But yeah, he was a big reason why the Lions won so easily last night.
Now it's looking like Daniel Tulloch for the New York Lions is injured. He's having trouble putting some weight on one of his ankles. He's rightfully going to sit on the bench. Now it's Rados who replaces him. Rados, the co-captain of this team. Of course, the other co-captain being David Tyndale. As the Lancers now have the ball.
Speaking of David Tyndale, he hasn't been too noticeable in this game. And there we go, right as I say, there is the basket right down the other way for Tyndale. But what I was saying was he hasn't been, not so much in this game, but definitely in the second half, he hasn't been too noticeable. And just as I was saying it, he made me speak my own words there, or stop talking right there.
The three attempt is no good, but there's a pass to Rados who slows it down. Looks like he can't do anything with it as Tefejic now gets it with the aggressive drive, but it's no good. Now Tyndale with the ball driving to Tefejic with the big slam, much to the delight of the crowd. This game is certainly getting exciting.
And Tyndale on the far right side calling for the ball there. You could hear him. You can even hear him calling to Rados to get him the ball. And once Rados did feed him the ball, that's the right plan for them. Because he had to Fedjic and he laid down the slam.
Now, apparently, Fedjic will be handed off a technical foul for that dunk. Not exactly sure why. Maybe he had a bit too much enthusiasm on the slam. But it certainly got the crowd in it. With Josh Collins putting a dagger in their hearts, getting that free throw. Head coach Tom Olivery asking what exactly happened on that technical foul. Now the Lancers looking to make that lead a bit bigger, but it's Tefejic. Will he slam again? No, he doesn't. Just the layup, but the crowd is loving it. And he's loving it too. You can see the emotion on his face as the Lions trying to make a comeback here. Because they're only down by 6.
Yeah, that's the closest they've been since, I've got to say, halfway through the first. A big rebound there by Kuldia, and they bring it back the other way.
More pressure by the Lions as Rados from downtown, but it's no good. But he gets his own rebound. Then it bounces off his leg into the Lancers forward's arm. But there's a kickball. As there's a stoppage in play here.
It's pretty funny to think about. We were talking about how the Lancers had slowed down the game a bit. It seemed like the game has picked up speed once again. And it's the Lions who are taking hold.
Jaden Pindale with another layup. There from number four, David Tindale, as now he's pressuring the ball holder. So the ball goes around the arc. Now a drive here and a layup, but it's no good. Some nice effort there from Osentola Jr. as he goes to the line once again tonight. J. Rudy on the court replacing Tefejic, who probably needs a much-deserved rest after those emotional plays, those big dunks.
Yeah, definitely. He's had quite the appearance so far in the second half. And give him a little bit of breather, but I don't think it'll be too long. He'll be back out very shortly.
And a shot from downtown once again. In and out. No good. Now the Lancers looking to score. Around the arc. And an open shot, and it's good. From number 22, Leon Phillip. Tindale quarterbacking the offense once again. Beats his man. Another shot from downtown from Isaac, but it's no good. Pardon me, from Ihedindu.
Rebound there from TJ Ruddy. Tall guy. Tall, lean point guard. Or not point guard, sorry. Guard right there for the Lions.
Score now 51-43 for the Lancers. As there's just about 3:50 left in the third quarter. Nice defensive effort there from the Tim, number 23 for the Lancers. And he will sit down as there are a few substitutions. Josh Collins makes his way back to the court. Now Rados with the ball as he drives, but he dishes it off and a shot, but it's no good. Lancers getting those rebounds. Josh Collins trying to beat his man, and he does, but he dishes it out. Now number 7, Matthews, no good. Tindale gets the ball as they rush down the court. York gets the basketball here.
You can see the Lancers on the last few defensive meters. They've tried to keep the ball to the outside. Ahedindu had a couple shots from beyond the three-point mark. Was not successful. And why not keep them beyond that three-point mark? We talked about at the beginning of the half how they had a percentage under 15%.
Clearly not happy with the officials right now. This is going to be two shots for pushing. Which kind of makes you wonder why they weren't happy. Rados will inbound it. As he finds Tindale. Now Rados with the shot. For three, no good. Lancers getting once again another defensive rebound as Collins makes his way down the court. with the layup, and it's good. Some nice effort there from Josh Collins, number 5 of the Lancers. And now York is going to try to answer right back. Tyndale trying to beat his man one-on-one, and the shot goes up. A nice board there from David Tyndale.
Exactly what the Lions need to keep doing. I talked about how the defense of the Lancers were keeping them to the outside, and they're simply not successful, the Lions, from the outside. So they need to keep driving to the basket to get those points.
Lancers trying to expand that lead. Trying to respond here.
Yeah, we talked about how the Lions aren't being successful from the three-point range. Something that the Lancers have continued to do well throughout this quarter and the whole game, keeping a percentage over 50%.
Three on the shot clock. Rado's shot goes up, but it's no good, and there's going to be a violation here. But it's overturned, apparently. Now Josh Collins with the ball. There's a shot, but it's no good. And Tyndale making his way. Look at that speed. Nice little move, and the layup is good. What a play by David Tyndale, who just beats two defenders for the layup.
That seemed like Petrella. It seemed like Petrella and Ismar Seferovic could not handle him there. He just snuck right through with that speed and got right to the basket.
Shot by De Loreto is no good. Rados with the ball as he drop pass for Tyndale with the three, but it's no good. Close though. And now a foul on number 5, De Loreto, from the Chancers.
Not sure why David Tyndale decided to go for that field goal there. He's been so successful driving to the basket, I think he should stick to that.
Tyndale gets the inbound. Calling out the play, looking for the open man, but there's no one ready. As now the ball goes out of bounds. But York retains the possession. Daniel Tulloch inbounding this one. He sees Tyndale at the top of the key. Tulloch once again with the ball. Pass was no good. Now a foul on number 4, Josh Collins. And it's looking like Christian Goldea is at the line.
Need to keep doing that. Keep driving into the basket. And imagine that is what Tom Oliveri is telling his squad right now, is to keep doing that. You're so successful right now with the speed, driving to the basket. And as we saw in this half, really that's what has been the difference in this quarter, has been driving to the basket and keeping it from the outside, keeping it on the inside.
And Goldea with his second free throw, and it's good, as there's only 31 seconds left in the third quarter. The Lancers trying to do something with this possession, as their lead is cut to 8 points, but it's been around there all night long. And Petrella with some nice effort, and he passes it to the open man, but it's no good. Lancers are not happy, voicing their displeasure here. York ball. interesting to see what happens here with 3 seconds left. 3:56.
Everyone yelling over here. It's kind of hard to realize exactly what is going on.
Seconds left. We'll see what happens as the shot goes up. Close, but no cigar from Tyndale. As the York Lions trail by 8 points to the Lancers. And it's bound to be an exciting fourth quarter. Welcome back to the Tait Mckenzie Center here at York University. As the fourth and final quarter between these two teams, being the Lions and the Lancers, begins. York trailing by 8 points. There's a whistle, and the Lions will get possession of the ball. Now the Lions are going to have to work inside that key if they want to score, if they want to get out of here with a win.
Yeah, in that third quarter, that was their first quarter of this game where they had the point advantage. They outscored them 20-18 in that third quarter. Much of the reason, you could see that they were driving to the basket a lot more. They were 0 for 5 from 3-point range and now are 1 for 13 in the game.
There's a foul on the play here. As number 22, Leon Phillips, shot the ball, so he will get a chance at redeeming himself as he goes to the line to shoot two. A few substitutions are made. Delretto back on the court.
Yeah.
had a big game playing 23 minutes so far. As Liam Phillips misses the first free throw. But he gets the second. Tyndale with possession, going in for the drive. And a huge block there by number 9, Ryan Christie. Good defensive play. And on the other side, the Lancers just can't finish, but there's a whistle. There's going to be a foul, I believe, on the Lancers. Yes, on the Lancers, and York will get the ball here.
Yeah, good job there by David Tyndale. It didn't turn out for the best. He got rejected pretty hard, but he's got to keep doing that. That shouldn't stop him from continuing the drive to the basket.
Tyndale having the advantage when it comes to speed, but clearly outsized there on this basketball court. Now Josh Collins gets an uncontested layup. Good for 2 points. And a big foul there on Di Loretto. Lancers coaching staff not happy with the officiating right now. As York gets another possession and a chance to score and cut this lead down, currently trailing by 11 points as the score is 59 for the Lancers and 48 for the Lions.
Yeah, Coach Chris Oliver continues to make a lot of noise from their bench, and gotta think maybe he should just keep it a little quiet. You feel like, you know, there's some refs out there who, when they get a lot of noise, that just kind of instigates them and gets them to want to make the coach a little more upset. You gotta just keep it quiet sometimes and let the play happen as it does.
Di Loretto easily making his way in the key, but he misses the shot, and now Tyndale with the layup. It's no good, but a big slam by number 23, Daniel Pullock. Pumping up his team with that play.
It's just the team pumping up the crowd. They are into it right now, and they got to just keep it strong, keep it aggressive, keep it speedy.
And the Lions with the ball once again. And the Lancers coaching staff, as I said, clearly not happy with the officiating.
Honestly, I know I was saying that. You should,
Good for three, David Tyndale. As the lead is cut to 6 points for the Lancers. That's their smallest lead of the game. Now the ball goes out of bounds, but the Lancers will have possession.
And what I was saying before, I was saying that Coach Oliver on the Lancers side should keep it down a bit, but I can totally understand why he was upset with that block from Fulday. It looks like he got a lot of hand on the Lancers player. The Lancer player, though. I don't think that could have gone either way. I think that should have definitely been a foul for the Lions.
Di Loretto with the ball, with the shot as well, but it's no good as Isaac has possession now. They're going to look to cut this lead down. To Fedic making his way down the key. Nice little move there. Lancers call a timeout. Clearly disappointing.
Wow. got to give it to Tander. So, like, they're a great offensive rebound. It is now a four-point game, two-possession game at the moment.
College and university students can save 10% on current
services. Lights just aren't pumping up the fans. I'm telling you, they're pumping me up right now. This is quite a game we have going on right now.
Resuming here, as the Lancers have the ball, it'll be Di Loreto inbounding the ball. Lions putting a lot of pressure in the Lancers zone, making it harder for them to cross half. Killing some seconds there on the shot clock. There's a shot that goes up, but the Lancers get the possession again. That's Josh Collins with the ball as he drives and passes it out to Di Loreto, but a big block from Tefecic. But the Lancers will regain the ball with 13 seconds on the shot clock.
And a lot of emotional play going on right now. Both teams have their starters out on the floor other than Christian Koldia. He has been substituted for Eric Rados. So the best players are on the court right now.
Daniel Tulloch not happy about that one. But Tyndale trying to respond. Calling out the play. Now he's double teamed. At least he was for a while. Now with the open shot from downtown. No good. A little tip, but he will get fouled on this one. A bit too aggressive from David Tyndale. He's not happy about that one. Oh, and it's a double foul.
As I've said, I don't like that decision there by Tyndale. I think that the Lions, I would be furious if I was Coach Oliveri. I think they have to continue to drive to the basket. I don't want to see any shot from beyond the arc.
No foul on the play, out of bounds. York still with the basketball, 9 seconds on the shot clock. And all we're hearing here on the desk is the disappointment from the Windsor coaching staff. But Rados from downtown, no good air ball. Wasted possession there. It actually went off the Lancer player. So Rados will inbound it again. 3 seconds left to Fejic with the shot. No good, though.
I honestly don't know how many times I can keep saying it. I don't know why Coach Oliveri hasn't taken a timeout and pretty much pressed it on his squad to stop taking those long distance shots. It's not working. I don't know how or how long it's going to take them to finally realize that, but that long distance shot is not working. They got to keep driving to the basket.
Now from downtown, no good. Rados with possession, but he loses it for a while, but he regains it once again. Now bringing it up the court, passes it to Isaac, who calls out the play. Collins being a bit more patient here. Tofegic with the big layup. But now the big slam from the Lancers, number 12, Osen Tola Jr. And now the other way. Another slam. This one from Daniel Kulik. Offense on both sides of the court here.
What a quick game right now. You cannot be left standing in this game right now. You got to be just right on it. Ball is just going back and forth.
And jump ball here. Lancers head coach telling his team to stay calm. Lots of excitement in the last few plays. And both teams scoring early and often in this one.
They still need to know the ball either. That's
fine. Koldia is now on the court. He's replacing Rados. With 4:20 left in this fourth and final quarter. Shot from Collins, and it's good. The Lancers now lead by 6. A nice little play from Tyndale there as he passes it to Isaac, but it's called for a travel. And the boos, you can hear the boos in this stadium right now. Home fans not happy. Seems both teams not happy with the officiating at times in this one. Leon Phillip brings up the ball, and now Collins with it, with an uncontested layup. But it's no good. Tofegic with the rebound. Here comes Tyndale. So they go in the key, a nice layup there. And there's a whistle on the play. Ryan Christie has committed a foul there.
Daniel Tulik has been absolutely a beast in this second half. Offensive board, I don't know really exactly what the Lancers can do.
Yes, Daniel Tulik with a great performance, both an offensive performance and defensive performance. And if the Lions can come out with the win here, a lot of credit is going to have to go to him.
Maybe after those two free throws right there, maybe that is the answer there. As soon as he drives, foul him. Almost kind of the Shaq type of rule from the NBA.
Isaac with the ball. Passes it to Tyndale. The hoop and the foul. And one. The crowd is loving it. Tyndale's loving it. The whole Lions are loving it. And I'm loving it.
Yeah, Austin, you've got to get to know. You can see why he is a team leader, a campus leader in terms of athleticism. The kid doesn't stop. He seems like he's played almost this whole second half, and he continues to drive up and down the court.
So it's now a one-possession basketball game with 3:19 left in this quarter. Things getting interesting here at Tait Mckenzie Center. As number 23, Mattim. Pardon me, number 9, Ryan Christie, who got the bucket. And he will go for one more, and one.
Daniel Tulik, his fourth personal, 2 seconds.
Good job there by the Lancers, giving the Lions almost a little bit taste of their own medicine, really driving it in deep to the basket.
David Tyndale, always dangerous. making his way down the key with the shot. Nice floater from David Tindale. As the score is now 68-64 for the Lancers. And the Lions regain possession. Clearly a bad call from the referees there. It's going to go to the Lions. A lucky break for them. Ball clearly hit David Tindale's hands on the way out. And there's a timeout called with just 2:40 left in this one.
I kind of have to thank the timeout there too. I need a little bit of a breather as well. Wow, this fourth quarter has been absolutely amazing with the game level and speed that it's at right now. Both teams played well in this second half. It's been a close game. And honestly, I think this is a game that can come down to the final shot.
Now, if it does go to the final shot, we're obviously going to be looking at David Tindale here, who had a clutch performance against the Brock Badgers. He actually won it with the game-winning shot in the final seconds. Of course, it was a free throw, but still, a clutch performance.
Yeah, a shot is a shot, and on the other side, in that game, when they played against the Carlton Ravens, they had trailed for three quarters, but then in the fourth quarter, appeared to be heading to a loss, but Windsor rallied up to put 18 points up in the final frame to beat the Ravens. Held the Ravens to just 6 to win that one there.
Sounds good to me.
Daniel Tulloch inbounding the ball.
Oh, really?
Tindale with it now. As he drives like he has all game long, but Lancers get the possession and the foul is called. Unsportsmanlike foul. Nick DeFedjic of the Lions. It seems like that play drained all of the Lions' energy. As you can look, you can see the look of despair on their faces right now. Not happy about that. And Tindale now with the club telling his team to calm down. Because clearly they are still in it.
Could have been the turning point of the game, but lucky for the Lions, Nana Tim missed his second shot, so it was still only a 5-point game.
Some big pressure here from the Lions. Not letting the Lancers get a shot off, but there is one for three, and it's good. That one might just be the dagger. As it's 72-64 with just 2 minutes to go in this one. And now it's Tindale driving. A shot from three-point range, no good. Hits the backboard, that's it. Lancers get the ball back. It's Josh Collins. Slowing things down here. And it looks like number one enemy for the Lions is going to be the time left in this game.
And the fact that it is an 8-point game, so really it's going to come down to them having to take 3-point shots to try and bring it back closer. But as we've talked about, they've not been good from beyond the arc.
Tindale gets fouled, and he will go to the line and shoot three. And this could have a big outcome on the game.
Yeah.
like we said earlier, Tyndale has been in some situations where he had to get some big free throws in tough times. Now just 1:11 left.
Yeah, this is going to be one of them. You saw Nana Tim had those that opportunity after that foul by Tvecic for that personal foul. Or, sorry, unsportsmanlike foul. He missed one of two, but then right after they got the ball back, he hit that three, which made it an eight-point game. This is going to be a point where, as he does, he gets both of them for his team. Both the first two. He needs to make this last one, so keep it close.
Tyndale perfect for all three, and the Lancers call a timeout. It'll be interesting to see how both teams are going to play in this last minute and 11 seconds. Getting some last minute advice from their coaches. And we're bound to see some big plays here.
Now this is going to be a big, big defensive. You'll have to be a big defensive play here by the line. So get the ball back as soon as they can. Try and drive up the court and get the ball back. Because, as you said before, time is going to be the biggest enemy for the line right now. Only a minute 11 left in the game. We're down by five. So this next possession for the Lancers is huge. It's a close game.
Lancers up by five, so it's still a two-possession basketball game. Lions could get a lead with two three-pointers in a row.
They come when they want. I said they don't. They, when the buzzer goes, they don't come. They wait until they're ready to go.
Big foul there on Richard Ihedindu. And De Loretta will go to the line and possibly get the winning shots here with the free throw. Sinks the first one, makes it a 6-point game.
Yeah, these shots right here could really put this game out of reach for the Lions, but he does miss the second one, so still a two-possession game.
Tyndale with the shot for three, and it's good! It's a three-point game now with 56 seconds left. The Lancers coming down the field. They're going to have to score on this one for some insurance, as it's in the hands of Josh Collins, looking for the open man. Cannot find anyone right now. He's double teamed. And the ball goes to Leon Phillips. And he shoots and he drains it. 39 seconds left. And a timeout is called.
Huge bucket right there by Leon Phillips. And on the other side, can you imagine that? We've been talking this whole game about how the Lions need to stay away from shooting those three pointers. And you know what? There was huge for David Tyndale to make this a close game. But you know what? We've come to that point where that's really their only chance. They're going to have to get as many points as they can at once. And most of the time, that's going to be taking those deep shots.
David Tyndale, understanding you need to take risks if you want to be successful. And there's still a lot of time for the Lions to get a lead, but they're going to have to score fast. Just a bit less than 40 seconds left on the clock. 75-70 for the Lancers in game two of this home opening weekend for the Lions. Reminding you that if the Lions win, they will be on a three-game winning streak.
The two options that the Lions will have right here is obviously feed the ball to the outside and triangle for three, but the other option as well is going to feed it into Daniel Tillich, who's been so successful inside the basket.
And a huge 5-second violation there. Rados not able to give the ball, to inbound the ball, pardon me. Now the Lancers with possession of the ball. This clearly hurts the Lions' chances of coming out with a win. As the ball successfully inbounded, Rados with the necessary foul to stop the play.
Your foul.
And Josh Collins will be at the line. Missing the free throw here. Ball's in Tyndale's hands. And a three-pointer. But it's no good. And the Lancers get possession and another foul.
It's not the kind of guy you want taking your 3 points in the bucket right there. Daniel Tillich is a guy you should keep in the paint, close to the paint. I would have liked to see either one of the Isaacs, either Hakeem Isaac or Raheem, taking that shot there.
Now Ryan Christie at the line. He could very well win this game with the insurance from those points as he sinks the first one. A second score here at the free throw line will make this a three possession basketball game, which it does, 77-70. And the York Lions hoping for a miracle here.
Yeah, I think they rushed that last opportunity they had on the offensive side. Daniel Tillich is not the guy you want to take the shot. Not that he's the guy who's missing the free throws. How do you think it's going to turn out when you send him a few feet back beyond the three-point line? He should have been. He should have waited a little bit of time, had him gone a little further towards the basket, have him within the paint there, and either feed it into him by 7-4, or either keep it to the outside. But if you're going to keep it to the outside, have your guys who can get those three, Isaacs or Tyndale, being able to get that shot. If not, do that. Feed it into Tillich in close to the basket, and if not, score in the basket, have a free throw.
Inbounding the ball, finds Tyndale. And Tyndale with the quick layup. Not sure. Tyndale will be shooting for two. He does. Both benches and the crowd screaming at the officials. Tyndale missed. misses the first one, which is odd for him.
You expect him to make that one right there. He made three earlier to make it a close game, and now he misses two. But
he gets the rebound of his own shot, and he sinks it in.
Those free throws he had just missed, it almost looked like he was kind of expecting and used that as a trick there to play it off the rim and get the rebound. But great job from him. Misses two free throws and makes it up.
Seconds left in this one. 77 for the Lancers, 72 for the Lions. This one might go right down to the wire.
Single one, because, you know, 17 seconds left, under 24 shot clock. You expect the team, especially when it's over a 1 point possession, it's currently 5 point difference, 2 point possession. Expect the Lancers, or the Lions rather, to be fouling the Lancers whenever they get the ball.
Lions back on the court, gonna play some big defense here. As there's no more shot clock, but there is a foul, as we expected. And the Lancers go back to the line once again. Josh Collins shooting. Nails the first one, which makes it a 6 point game. The second, which is now a three possession basketball game. Final 10 seconds of the game. Tyndale with the shot. No good. As the Lancers get the ball, and they're just going to kill the time here. Fouled once again. Diloretto will go to the line. Put some pad on the scoreboard there to make this win look a bit bigger than it really was.
Yeah, definitely cemented the lead as teams that usually have more than a one possession lead going down to the final minutes of the game, they're going to get those final free throws. But this was a close game for most of the second half. Great job by the Lions to really get rid of that lead, that big lead that the Lancers had for most of the first half. But if I have to go to one play here, it was that moment when Donovan hit that three-pointer, made it a possession game. That's where I look.